which time they can maneuver, descend, and fly by in a show of force. The team will display a belly pass now in front of us so you can appreciate the beauty of six aircraft in tight formation. Now, if you look closely, you might see the Geico Gecko riding along with the team. Search the team's YouTube channel for the Gecko Airshow commercial to see how his first flight went. Hacker. There's the pitch, and here goes the break. Folks, watch how they miss each other by just mere feet. That right there is the six-plane implosion. Now, once they're city taken, you can engage head on and fly through to complete the strike, or you can turn and engage the threat in a classic dogfight. In a turning engagement, the aircraft try to meet as close as possible, head to head, in order to gain an advantage. But now let's see what happens with the four plane and the two plane. Now we see the four plane, now we have the two plane. Now you watch the left and I'll watch the right. As these two formations begin to approach, they're now turning head on with a closing ratio of around 320 miles per hour. Now the options for the pilots are either to continue, roll out, or bug out. The Solos were smart and they bugged out right there, maintaining a constant watch. The Diamond must now stay alert and focused as they continue their turn and roll out for further targets. When they do, you'll get an opportunity to enjoy the symmetry of the Skytyper Diamond formation. Straight ahead as the Solos come in to give you a classic example of one versus one, 1v1 air-to-air engagement. Now this is where the pilot's skill is the only thing that makes a difference. Watch as the Solos shackle to clear each other's 6 o'clock position. And they're also going to watch for any aircraft that might sneak in there as they split apart with equal energy before they begin turning towards each other for the always impressive head-on pass. Now from the left and from the right, watch as both of these two Solos engage. Fights on at that point. First, the Solos pitch into each other, and then they turn in the same direction. Now setting up a one-circle fight. Wing Solo will soon, we'll watch him, disappearing behind his own smoke. He's going to gain a little bit more energy in that attempt. Again, trying to get an advantage. Now watch here in this turn. This is what we're talking about. Watch as he begins to overtake. He's going to take his shot right there, and as that lead Solo is forced to fly in an unpredictable path, as we've seen, that, of course, is called the gun's jink. Now wait, did you see what just happened? The lead Solo does a surprise move there by going out wide, which caused that reversal. So So now he went from offense to defense. The hunter becomes the hunted. These aircraft use around a 6 of diamond is back in to demonstrate their ability to maneuver in a close formation, highlighting the skills of the pilots while they work hard to stay wingtip to wingtip while climbing, descending, and turning. As the formation pitches up, the flight leader needs to be smooth and precise so his wingmen can follow his exact and every move. As they turn, the wingman on the outside needs to turn to increase power, since the travel distance is greater, while the wingman on the inside of the turn doesn't go as far, so they actually reduce power. The red, white, and blue stripes on each aircraft are reference marks that help the pilot keep that precise position. Now the smoke you see, threats have been neutralized. Now let's focus on those targets out there in the water. Ground targets are identified to require different tactics. Watch from your left as the Solos demonstrate a series of tactical turns to position themselves to deliver their ordnance in a high-speed, low-level pass. Straight in front, watches that echelon formation pops up and demonstrates a forward air controller position like a back. They're going to pop up there and surprise the enemy and straight tight down onto air show center. That's number one up there in front, Larry Arkin, the boss. Two, Chris Thomas. Three, Mike Grumpy. And number four, Kevin Simbaldi. Watch them skyward as they cross. See what they're doing for you again. Ladies and gentlemen, that is none other than the Solo's heart, flown today by Steve Salamars and Tom Daly. They maximize the performance of their aircraft using the flight displays. Ladies and gentlemen, the Geico Skytypers bomb first. Now with aircraft all over the sky, it is critical that each pilot keep track of all, turn left, rejoin Delta formation now. Now as the team sets up for a special pass, the Geico Skytypers would like to recognize the men responsible for keeping these vintage military aircraft in such fine condition. The aircraft technicians are Frank Atrio, Mike Beecroft, Mac McMillan, and Greg Coons. We'd also like to recognize, dedicated to all of the members of the United States military, is the Geico Skytypers Fan Pass. Right there in front of us, they're going to cross just in front of each other now after that fan pass. Besides staying close for mutual support, being unpredictable confuses those attackers out there. Keep your eyes on the Geico Skytypers as they demonstrate another of their unique methods for combining 6 separate aircraft into a single formation as quickly and safely as possible. All military pilots and all military aircraft, including the jet teams, utilize this particular skill. A majority of the pilots on the team earn their wings through military training in the Air Force, the Navy, and the Marines. The Geico Skytypers would like to invite you to learn.